Hey guys, it's Dr. Erin here at Focus TV Network in West Hollywood. And if you're anybody who's desiring love, connection, sex, marriage, all the above, you don't want to miss this one because we have Marla Martenson here today. How are you?
Hi, Erin.
Yay, I'm so glad you're here.
So happy to be here.
Marla and I, she's a matchmaker, amazing matchmaker here, boutique matchmaker. Mm-hmm. She does Reiki, she does crystal healing. And we had an interview, what was it, like a year ago?
Yeah, a year and a half ago at your place. We
yeah.
set everything up on Facebook Live. It was
right.
great.
We're moving on up.
It's so fun.
So I love the conversation about dating, relationships, and love. It's been everywhere I go, it seems like it's the conversation. And I love that you're a matchmaker, but at the same time, I feel like even people who are married are constantly dating. They're dating even their husbands and wives. It never ends, I don't think. Do you think?
Well, it doesn't, and we have to keep it spicy. You know, we're a mm-hmm. society that is kind of throwaway. Let's move on to the next. We have mm-hmm. such a high divorce rate even, or relationships that don't last. I match people. I've had people, I've been doing this 16 years, so imagine I've had couples get married and then get divorced and come back for another and hire me again to find them someone else. I mean,
right.
you know, so...
So much fun. So first of all, I want to know matchmaking, because we have Bumble, we have Tinder, we have all these ways. We have so much options, especially
yes.
in LA, that it's overwhelming. In fact, I think
right.
it almost hurts people of finding people sometimes because there's so many options.
It can, and because humans are so visual, especially men. So when you have these apps that like Tinder that you're swiping,
yeah.
you're just looking for the best looking person really, right? It's not, you're not looking, thinking about that other list that you have of qualities in a person. And of course you want to be attracted to someone, but I think that leaves a lot of people out who might not be photogenic, who might not be a mm-hmm. model look. So that's a shame too.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
And the reason why I love you so much as a matchmaker is because you're spiritually based, because you're conscious. So it's not just about the surface thing. And I know you get to the heart of the matter. And so I want to have a deeper dive into mm-hmm. matchmaking. You know, what do you see people, you see when it works and doesn't work. What do you think works for people? Why, what is it that has two people come together and have it really work, in your opinion?
Well, it is that deeper dive, because when you're just looking for the surface stuff, which we often do, hey, we're in Los Angeles and some of the other bigger cities, I see, even with my men, so yeah, I'm very spiritually based, but my guys usually aren't so much. They're the high-powered mm. men, and they want the most beautiful woman they can mm. find, right? And so I try to get them off of that, you know, picking off of a photo, because they want me to send them the photos, and go a little bit deeper. So, you know, I push, you know, mm-hmm. I kind of mm-hmm. open them up, get them some coaching, get them to do some energy healing sometimes. Mm-hmm. I've done long distance Reiki. I have all my files. I work from home and I'll send them some energy. I'll put them in my Reiki box with a crystal, you know. I kind of do some behind the scenes healing work, because, we get caught up in that.
Like, but so
shiny,
what is it?
The baubles,
so two
right?
people come together in, like, there's chemistry and it works on all level. What?
Yeah.
Do you just think it's just a crazy, miraculous thing that happens?
Well,
or do you think there's actually some common denominators to that?
It can be. You know, you meet someone and you think, oh, it's just fate. You know, we were here at this party together, or somebody matched us up. But when we're vibrating at a high frequency, so yeah. here comes the spiritual component. Mm-hmm. When we are happy with our lives, when we feel good in our body, and when, since we are energy and everything's energy, when our energy's high, we're going to start attracting like-minded people and great people into our life, business, mm-hmm. money, everything. Mm-hmm. And if you think about it, if you're down, if you're depressed, if you're complaining, what mm-hmm. happens? You lose a client, you can't get anything going, you have these duds for dates, or you
yeah.
get cheated on, and that's just how it goes.
There's
so.
Nothing worse. I have clients who go, I went on this date, and they complained the entire
time.
And you're
oh.
thinking, whoa, do they not know basic 101 of energy?
Well, this is a big thing, because I get the feedback after dates, and mm-hmm. so many men will say, Marla, my date treated the evening as a
counseling session.
as a therapy session,
right?
As a therapy session. And that just think about it. So here's a man, mm-hmm. If you're a woman going out with a man, he's a high level, maybe CEO, a doctor, something. He's working all day really hard, and he's thinking, oh my gosh, I'm so stressed, but tonight I'm having dinner with this beautiful woman. I'm going to have some great conversation, some nice wine, take her out. And then she arrives, maybe late, maybe harried, you know, looking at her phone and then complaining the whole time about her. She doesn't have money for
like,
her rent.
Yeah, he's like, sign me up for that
ex.
One.
And then it's like so disappointing.
So
and then
disappointing.
He gets the, you know, bill for $200 or $300 for dinner, you know. So,
yeah. To be present. That
right.
might be,
you gotta be present.
Number one thing for sure. In fact, in our, you know, our interview a year ago or whatever, I've used our distinctions because we sat down before and we thought, you know, what are some real good tips we can give to everyone? I think we came up with the five tips together, which is okay. so amazing. And the one distinction of having transcending versus transactional relationships, I've used that in so many conversations
great.
Over the year, and I really truly believe that. So I want to get into that. So remember when we talked about it. So for example, somebody who needs to, you know, transactional, for example, you said you have a lot of gentlemen per se that, you know, the women want a free meal or the next handbag or whatever, and the guy wants the hottest woman. So it's like it's a transactional thing. Or if somebody needs to have somebody that's abandoning them, they'll pull in somebody that needs to abandon. It's a transactional thing. And so I'm wondering, how do you deal with that? Like, how do you have that conversation with your clients? You say, I can get you the hottest woman, but you need to know that this mm-hmm. is most likely a transactional relationship.
Well, all of my, so I know it sounds really shallow, but this is just the business model that I've always worked in. So the men are successful and the women, because they're paying a lot of money to us, they do want a very attractive, you know, our American standard, slender, beautiful woman, right? So that's what they're looking for. They're not going to pay us $10,000, $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 to meet a lady they could just meet on, you know, an average look. I mean, it sounds terrible, but that's their, they say, Marla, I'm not going to pay you $20,000 to meet an average looking woman I can meet at Starbucks.
Okay. But wait. So, because you're a spiritual woman.
Right.
How are you doing with that?
Oh, yeah.
How are you doing with that?
I know. So I do. But so, yes, it may sound transactional. Okay, yes, you can meet a beautiful woman, but whatever they think is beautiful, you know, like guys have different looks. I want a brunette. I want someone more curvy. I want someone skinny, redhead, whatever. Okay, we get that. It's more the age range that is, I have to tell them that. So I have a guy, he's almost 50. He's been dating 20 somethings, 30, early 30s, and doesn't work out. And he doesn't want to go over mid 30s. And I say, well, listen, you're now in your late 40s. Things aren't working out. You're not happy with the way the girls are. They're flaky, this and that. You're dating too young.
Wow.
You know,
oh
you're dating
gosh.
Too young.
I can't wait to hear more about it. We actually have to take a little break.
Okay.
But I think this is so important because going from transactional to transcending is a complete shift in spiritually, mentally, physically, everything. So when we come back, what I want to do is I want to hear some tips of what you'd have for men and women out there to go from one thing to the next. What would you recommend for them, okay?
Okay.
So stay tuned, you guys, for some hot tips of going from transactional relationships to transcending and truly getting what you want out of life. Stay tuned. Hi there, I hope that you're enjoying this great conversation. I'm here at Focus TV Network in West Hollywood, America's first streaming video talk network. And I want to hear your story. We would like to showcase your story about consciousness, awakening, and spirituality. So you can reach out to me at below. You'll see right here my email and all of our contact information. We want you. Now back to the show. Guys, we're back with Marla Martenson. She's a matchmaker, and we're going to talk about the hacks of going from a transactional relationship to a transcending relationship, which means basically going from your vicious cycle of dating, trying to get something that is just
right.
delusional, to basically getting to a place where you're really thriving and really getting deep, profound love, right? I mean,
yeah, it's that again, that those shiny objects that you see, okay, well, that guy's got a Rolls Royce or he looks like George Clooney or she's, you know, the hottest ticket in town. And, you know, it's kind of diving a little deeper. I would say, make your list of 50. This is what my friend and coach Susan Allen says. Make your list of 50 to 100 qualities. Write it down of what you're looking for in a person, positive statements. And you're going to have that in your subconscious. It's not that somebody has to tick off every single thing, but you're going to get this idea more than just looks. So let's say there's women that I know who are single after a decade because they prefer their high heels over a quality man. So, I don't date. I know I'm only 5'3", but I only date 6 feet and over because I live in my heels. I wear 5-inch heels.
Wow.
Well, I hope you're going to you know, be very happy with those heels, and they keep you warm at night.
Right.
So
it seems like a lot of my single friends are very picky. You know, it seems like they date, and then as soon as there's one little thing, they're like, I'm out. And it's like, well, someone can't be everything.
No, that you want and that's to too kind of our throwaway society. And you can just swipe and swipe and swipe and find somebody else, and let's just move on. Oh, there's a red flag. So, yes, you have to be careful, but you got to give people a chance. I mean, if we look at ourselves, my gosh, I could, you know, have 10 red flags about me, you know,
going right? out once. So, we all do.
Yeah, we all do. So, there's things. I mean, my husband and I have, gosh, we're like Ricky and Lucy. He's a Latin musician, you know, kind of very passionate and gets, can get upset over any little things. And then I'm more, you know, I'm Lucy, just, you know, trying to get the show and, and doing my wacky stuff. But you have to realize that, gosh, you've got to let each other be who we are and kind of roll with the punches.
So the hack, so obviously doing internal work for going from transcending, maybe having a bigger picture, like what other hacks do you think someone can go to transcending?
Yeah, talking about that inner work. So it's like easy to say, but what do you do about it? So we're all damaged, you know, from, we can go back. Well, we're all wounded. I mean, we wouldn't be here on earth if we didn't have, if you believe in that light, earth is a school. Who do you know? You could look at every single person and think, well, they maybe have a lot of money, or they're gorgeous, or they're whatever, they have a life partner, they've got some issue, and you can go back to childhood. They were abused, or they were abandoned, or they were hurt, or they were bullied, or whatever. So it can go back to past lives if you want to go there, or or even at conception, what the DNA, or as a childhood. So we all have things.
You're speaking my language.
Yeah, we have things that we need to heal and clear. And I do have some modalities. If you go to my website, you can, people can work with me, MarlaMartenson.com. I have a new modality that I'm trained in, my liquid fish, that clears that out. I do energy healing, crystal healing. You know, if you want to get into A Course in Miracles, it's great. Mind training. There's a lot of things. So you do want to do that self work. There's so much, to delve. You could find, just dig into it, you know, and there's a lot of things. There's a, I have a self love guided meditation you can download for free on my website and put those positive affirmations in your head, because it's really all about self-love and self-esteem. And it comes down to that, loving yourself so much, because often we will, and we find women doing this a lot, we'll go for men who maybe verbally abuse us or put us down or don't show up or cheat. And it's going back to, why do we feel we deserve that? I had a lot of verbal abuse in my relationships, and I go back and think, well, I was bullied as a kid. I, you know, I can kind of trace some things back where Even I was at a luncheon with, or a dinner with some people, and I was sitting there, and I'm thinking kind of like, oh, I'm kind of the outsider. I felt like I was back in school and when the cool kids didn't want me around. And it was weird. And it's like, well, that's not the case. Nobody thinks of me like that. But that came up.
Completely. It all comes up to be healed. For sure.
Yeah.
So I think we have to take another break. But when we come back, I want to know a few things, because I know that you probably are dealing with you know, you're not dealing with millennials. You're dealing with, generally, I would say, probably like what?
40. The men are like 40s, 50s, 60s.
Yeah.
I have an 89-year-old.
Oh, there you go.
If there's any older ladies here.
He's hot to drop.
He's a widower, and he's great looking for somebody. And then the women, basically late 20s on up to mid 50s.
Okay. So when we come back, I want to know, if somebody's out there and they don't, they want to find a matchmaker, and like, what do they do even if they are, like first date etiquette, things like that.
Ooh, well,
right? So like the do's and don'ts of making the first contact, good conversation to the first date, things like do's and don'ts, okay? So stay tuned, you guys, because whether you're have a matchmaker or whether you're swiping on one of those apps, you wanna know what the feedback is from all of our clients, okay? So stay tuned, you guys.
Got that feedback.
And we are back at Focus TV Network talking about love, dating, relationships, and all that good juicy stuff with Marla Martenson, matchmaker here. So we're talking about the do's and don'ts on when you first meet people, whether it be if you're swiping on an app, whether you have a matchmaker, what are the do's and don'ts when you first meet someone?
And I'll give the guys a real tip here. Don't ask for women. Don't ask the women for more photos. Sometimes I'll make a match, and I know I've seen the woman. She's beautiful. I FaceTimed with her, met her in person, or I've seen a bunch of pictures. So I match them up. I send him a few photos.
Yeah,
he's hired me to match him. Right? Trust me. You know, to do it. And then he starts, gets the phone number, starts texting, hey, can you send me some more photos?
It's like a woman being like, so tell me your resume again. What do you do again? How much do you make again?
Yes. And the woman feels like, you guys, a piece of meat. She feels like all you want to do is see my pictures, see pretty pictures. What are you doing with them? That's kind of creepy. It's kind of gross. And then don't send her more pictures. Don't send her a picture of you in the bathroom with your shirt off as a selfie.
We do not want to see that.
There's so many of those bathroom selfies. No dirty towels in the background. No shirts off. No baseball caps. Don't pose in front of your Ferrari. It's so, you know. Okay, so that, have respect.
That's it's like, great advice.
Right? We've been introduced. Marla speaks highly of you. Can't wait to meet you. Trust it. Don't have to analyze every little, oh, she might have a wrinkle here in this photo, or, you know, her boobs aren't quite as big as I hoped. Or, you know, meet the woman. Get some person. Okay, test that. So first date. Texting, I had a guy text for an hour with a woman. I just matched them up, texting back and forth. And then she says, well, he was texting me, asking me about my previous relationships. Felt kind of weird. I said, what were you doing? He goes, oh, but it was an hour text. So it was appropriate because we spoke about many subjects. I said, you didn't pick up the darn phone.
Just pick up the phone.
And talked. So that's not really appropriate on a first contact to text for 1 hour.
Yeah.
Texting, leave it for, hey, just checking your schedule.
Completely.
I'm running late. I'll be there. What's the address?
Yeah. Whatever. I feel like it's a big red flag. If someone doesn't pick up the phone, that's like, why would you want to be in communicate? Yeah. Why would you want to be in a relationship with somebody who's not desiring to have
And I know, I understand there's times when I'm, even with a girlfriend or something, I'm texting because I'm like, I don't want to talk.
Of course.
This way it's shorter, but you're trying to make a good impression and meet the love of your life. Okay, so then when you arrive, always arrive on time. Sometimes ladies will arrive an hour late and they're like, they don't think it's a big deal.
Awful.
And the guy's fuming.
I've heard that a lot from clients.
It's not acceptable. And I know there's a lot of traffic, but leave early. I left to get here. It's only 8-9 miles away. I left an hour in advance to get here because I know the traffic. So, you know, put on a podcast in the car, do whatever you got to do to get through, you know, get there early. Be well groomed, put your phone in your purse or wherever you got to put that, turn it off, unless you're a doctor or you have a child, you know, babysitter.
Instagrammable moments in the middle of a first date.
So many times guys will tell me that the girl was on the phone texting and they, you know what they think? Oh, she's lining up another date for later or something.
Yeah.
So you don't know. Guys are guilty of it too. And girls are watching. How are you treating the waitress? How are you talking to the staff? Are you, this is a good one. Sometimes the guy will hey, let's split an entree. You know, I've had that one. The girl, you know, okay, so maybe you're
kind of people laughing in the background. Right
maybe you're on a budget, but save up for that date then and get her. You want to impress her at least on the first date, let her order. Even if it's, I know they serve too much food in the United States, you know, I take my food home. I could eat for 3 days on the portions here, but let her have it, you know.
Wow.
Don't drink too much. Recently I had a girl, she was drinking like 3 to 5 glasses of wine, started having a political argument, and then it ended.
So
you know, I get the text like, oh, I just left him. He does, you know, he's a conservative, and you know, and he says she had 5 glasses of wine. She was yelling at me, and I was like, oh my God,
wow.
All right. So I have to do kind of this damage control sometimes. And that's, if you have a matchmaker, hey, that's embarrassing for the matchmaker. Realize this is how I put food on the table. It's not only I'm a Cupid, I want everyone to find love, but this is how we pay our bills too. So you want to, these are clients that have paid money that hope to have a woman or a man who is serious and who has some etiquette and stuff. So don't, also, if you're going to work through a matchmaker, please treat that with respect and make the matchmaker look good.
Oh,
yeah.
That's so, it's so, I mean, everybody wants to see people have love in their life, have great relationship. And I can't imagine, it's got to be fascinating. So fascinating to deal with the human behavior of dating.
And it's gotten worse because I was on Facebook today and somebody just puts this rude comment about this one woman who was doing her little video about giving some dating tips and about her appearance. And it seems like it's okay to, we're hiding behind a screen or we're hiding behind a text or we've kind of become a little callous.
Yeah, for sure. You know, oh, so how can people find you? They can find you at MarlaMartenson.com.
Yeah. Yeah, everything's there. Everything's there. All my links and my healing, my matchmaking, my books. I have a YouTube show. I have a radio show now called The Mystical Matchmaker on Wednesdays. You can call in, and I often have psychics on. We'll do love readings.
Oh, that's
a lot of fun. Yeah, yeah.
Super fun.
Blood Talk Radio.
That's so fun.
Connect with me on my...
Oh, that's so wonderful. So thank you so much for coming in.
These conversations always go so fast.
I know they go so fast. And I just think what you're doing is so fun.
Thanks.
And I think it must be challenging being spiritual and bringing that in and yet allowing people to be wherever they're at.
I've had to dig deeper into my spirituality to handle some of the shallowness of it. But you know, I'm happy that I've done that and I can bring that to my clients.
Yeah. So you must have to hold space like not thinking negative about the client so that you can hold the
right
possibility of them meeting someone, right?
Yeah, because I don't want to judge. And mm-hmm. I used to as a woman, it would really bother me some of these things that they wanted, but I can hold them in a different kind of space now.
Interesting. And
yeah.
Good. So if you're looking for someone that's going to hold, you know, a space around you to really truly find love and just allow whatever's there. Marla's an amazing woman, very, very real. She gives really great energy, very down to earth, and yet realistic in today's world. People still have, you know, still have basic 101 human desires and needs. We're still like animalistic inside in some ways.
You wouldn't
right?
even want to know the things I did when I was single. Super embarrassing. So, as Oprah would say, I weep for the woman I was.
Oh, no, she does not say that, did she? That's hilarious. Okay, so you can look her up, Marla Martenson, and knowing that each and every one of us, there is the perfect expression of love, partner or partners, or marriage or dating or whatever that is. I respect everyone and everyone's expression of that love. And so may you live your truth. Thank you so much. Thanks for coming through.